pozdrav še enkrat, spoštovane gledalke, cenjeni gledalci, ljubiteljice in ljubitelji domačega nogometa. Z komentatorskega mesta čakamo torej na začetek srečanja 12. kroga v prvi ligi Telemach Olimpija Kalcer Radomlje. Luke Baša. Krefl. Še enkrat nevarnost in Olimpija vodi 1-0, strelec je Marcel Ratnik. Če ne gre iz igre, pa je Olimpija do priložnosti prišla z prekinitve in najmlajši v Olimpiji zasedbi Marcel Ratnik je dosegel zadetek, to je že njegov tretji gol v tej sezoni. Šošič poizkušal, Šošič zdaj strelja in obramba Vinovška. Prva nevarna akcija Radomljanov, tudi za ključkom 21. minuta. Nenatančna podaja Prpiča, nesporazum z Dakruzom. Nukič je zdaj krenil po desni strani, gleda razporeditev svojih soigralcev. 1-1 s Korunom, priložnost ima Nukič, tora naravnost Baša je sprožil. Mustafa Nukić, ena lepših priložnosti za Olimpijo. Silva za Floruča. Pa Diogo Pinto. Rui Pedro! Prekorak je sprožil Rui Pedro. Še ena velika priložnost za Olimpijo. Druga v razmaku zgolj. Dobre minute. Je padel, res prekrška po mnenju Matkoviča, Kruz, mislim, da je bil Šošič v offsajdu, ampak akcija se nadaljuje, Šošič strelja izenačenje, zdaj pa dvignjena zastavica, enoznačen prepovedan položaj. Ali pač, mislim, da ni bilo offsajda, mislim, da ni bilo prepovedanega položaja in da bo to gol za izenačenje. Morda tistega dogodka, ko je predtem padel. Elšnik, ja, offsajda pa ni bilo in Radomljani so preko Šošiča prišli do izenačenja. 1-1, v 35. minuti je zadel Mađid Šošić. Ni uspel tule dovolj dvigniti žoge Krefl, nobene nevarnosti. Fadida, napaka Fadide, Kruz in mimo vrat je zletela ta žoga. Kakšna napaka v Olimpijini obrambi, zdaj žvižgi namenjeni Ljubljančanom. Posavcu oziroma Vokiću pušča prednost Matković po prekršku kase. Na sredini igrišča Šošić ima priložnost, ostaja 1-1, še tretja krasna situacija za Radomlje v tem drugem polčasu. Jona Gorenca Stankoviča, Vokić je skočil, Posavac se bori o Bratniku, še ena priložnost, Vinovšek iz vrat, silovito trčenje, kaj so v nadaljevanju zgrešili Radomljani, ostaja 1-1. Upam, da je ni huje tule skupil Vidovšek ob tem trčenju. Ki soboti dvoboj z Avstrijo. Proti Pristriču je šla žoga, tu je zdaj Rui Pedro. Pedro Luka strelja, prečka! Sijajn strel je bil to Pedra Lukasa, tule zdaj do svoje prepovedan položaj. Odbija Ševel. Ino Kukovec, pa Karamatić, Kukovec je dobil tale zračni dvoboj, priložno za goste. Krolo, Posavec strelja in izvrstna obramba Pintola. V 96. minuti so imeli Radomljani še četrto veliko priložnost v tem drugem polčasu.
Plan before the match was 3 points at the end, 1 point. Your take of the game, what was missing today to get those 3 points?
Everything. We deserve to hear that for the stands. Very bad match from our team. And no excuses today. I say that maybe and probably this is the worst match that we have done this season. And when this happens, we are punished. And you have been punished with 2 points lost here today.
We are now thinking about lacking the energy. What was the reason today? Because in the second half, really, there was not really energy, not really enough creativity, not making enough chances. Everything was missing.
Yes, everything is missing. We try to put fresh blood, fresh legs. We try to incentivize them in the halftime because in the first half, okay, we have 1-0 and we have chances to do 2-0 before the draw. But it's not enough from all match. It's not enough. And of course, the fresh legs must come from outside and do better than they do today. The guys that are in the beginning that must do better than they did today. And games like this happens, but it's we have been punished for that. And we have to, of course, to refresh everyone mind. I told you in the beginning that is more mental fatigue than physical fatigue. I think this is the main problem. It's too many matches, but this today is not the reason because we try to manage with that, put different people inside that came from long stop from, for example, Raul. And it's not the problem of the individual. It is now today we collectively were not good. Individually, nothing is good for us. We cannot tell again the pitch. Okay, it's not good. It's not good for both teams. More difficult for the team that try to build. It's normal, but today we don't do enough to win. This is the reality, and we have to accept that. We have to change this because it's too many points to win. Is nothing the distance from Celje. Okay, we can recover, of course we can do it, but we are losing stupid points and we don't should do that. We must keep winning with big difficulty or less difficulty, okay, because the teams are pissed, are defending, are looking for the mistakes. And we did another mistake, no communication, we let them do two or three situations, dangerous situations, and without reason. We must do better. And they know what to do in this kind of situations, but today seems like they are restart everything again. So we have to now rest a little bit in this stop. 2-3 days, the stop is going to be good for everyone and come with mostly the mind fresh to restart again another month terrible with 7 matches in a few space. But this is what we expect to be. Today is not the excuse. Today we have done a bad match. Everything is going wrong. So we have to accept that. We have to accept the criticize from the stands. Okay, sorry for that, for the fans. We want more fans here today to help us, and not the few that come don't deserve this kind of match. They deserve a match with more energy, with more enthusiasm, with more quality. But today we didn't do it. Okay, 1 per season is enough. We lose the chance to do a bad match today. Finish, and the next ones we must do much better if we want to be champion, of course.
You came from Portugal. The pressure in Portugal is always big. The pressure in Olympia here is also for Slovenian environment big. You are feeling any pressure already or
no? Pressure is all the time. We must win from the beginning. The pressure to be in the first groups, pressure to win the matches, pressure every time. This is normal. Big clubs that want to win all the time is like this, and we are prepared for that because we know that doing this kind of schedule is not possible to be 100% in every match. But even when we don't are in 100%, we must win. But today, we didn't do the other part. Okay, we are not in 100%, but okay, let's win. Let's be pragmatic. And we don't do it today. But pressure is, of course, in big clubs every week. And this kind of schedule is every 3 days, we have the pressure. But it's normal. This is the kind of pressure that we are used to.
Gospod Bogatinov, mislim, da lahko rečemo čestitke za točko, čeprav na koncu ob tisti zadnji priložnosti malce obžalovanja, da niste vzeli kaj več, pa vendar le. Ali ne?
Ja. Poznate idejo, ki je bila izrečena pred tekmo. Smekli, da mi želimo danes iti pogumno v tekmo, samo tekmo in ne se toliko prilagajati Olimpiji in domačinom, kot pa graditi neke pozitivne zadeve, ki nam bi lahko koristile v nadaljevanju prvenstva, glede na to, da je še več kot 20 tekem do konca. Tako da ja, imeli smo neke priložnosti, hitro dobili gol, celo tista od Kruza je bila mogoče še lepša, vrata so bila prazna, Brazilci ponovaj to zadanje.
Zdaj nekako se kar veliko ukvarjamo s tem, kaj je danes manjkalo Olimpije, ampak to ni vaš problem. Z vaše strani me zanima, v čem so bile Radomlje danes morda celo boljše, da so bile na koncu, vendarle povsem realno gledano bliže zmagi.
Težko povem, to so vprašanja, s katerimi se obadamo mi vsakodnevno pri našem delu. Kako sem sam videl tekmo, je to, da mogoče to, kar sramežljivo smo šli zelo hitro, tudi prejeli zadetek. Nismo se upali, ni nam stekla žoga. Potem pa iz minuto v minuto na nek način smo rasli. Mogoče bilo to tudi za pričakovati, glede na to, da Olimpija je letošnja Evropska Olimpija in igra tudi med tednom v evropskem tekmovanju. In tako kot so šle minute proti koncu, tako smo mi tudi rasli.
Ta niz štirih tekem s temi, ki so trenutno na vrhu, je zdaj končan. Dve točki ste vzeli v tem obdobju, verjetno tudi v tem pogledu marsikaj dobrega. Zdaj za te tekme, ki prihajajo, za katere pa pravimo, da so tekmeci, ki so tu nekje.
Tako je in upam, da ta tekma bomo znali iz te tekme te velike pozitivne zadeve prenesti tudi na ostale ekipe. Normalno. Prve vrste bo veliko odvisno od nas, fanti danes veliko želje, energije in če bomo to znali prenesti tudi v naslednja kola, bom osebno zadovoljno pa verujem, da tudi še kdo drug.
Aljaž, hiter zadetek, zdelo se je, da se vse skupaj nekako začelo po vaših željah. Kaj je potem zmanjkalo predvsem v tem drugem polčasu?
Ja, se strinjam, dobro smo začeli tekmo. Potem pa enostavno prejeli zadetek, ampak predtem smo že imeli težave z nekimi kontranapadi, mi pa nismo uspeli izkoristiti prostoru, ki nam jih je Radomlje puščala. Ob tem smo jim pa mi puščali veliko preveč prostora za protinapade, v drugem polčasu pa enostavno nismo znali izkoristiti nekih priložnosti, biti konkretni v zadnji tretjini, si ustvariti neki konkretnejših priložnosti in danes je bilo zelo slabo iz naše strani.
Aljaž, v lanski sezoni ste postavili kar visoke standarde, vemo, rezultati so bili odlični, zdaj lahko morda rečemo prva malce manjša kriza. Kakšna je energija v slačilnici? Zdi se, da tudi na igrišču morda to včasih pogrešamo.
Ja bi rekel, gledajte, krivulja prejšnjo sezono je šla strmano vzgor. To je dostavno, ne more iti v nedogled. Sigurno pride kdaj pa kdaj trenutek, kjer malo padeš, kjer si malo v krizi. To je očitno trenutno, se to trenutno dogaja in ne bi pa rekel, da to slabo vpliva na nas. Mi smo enostavno super klapa. Delamo odlično, razumemo se odlično, enostavno mora nam spet zalaufati. Po domače povedano, ja, treba je tole reprezentančno pauzo izkoristiti na čim boljši način, strniti glave in nadaljevati v boljšem ritmu.
Čestitke za točko, nekako ste napovedovali, da ste po vsaj točko prišli, na koncu ste jo osvojili, nekako načrt je izpolnjen.
Da, ja bi najprej čestito momcima, svi su odradili jednu odličnu utakmicu i mi su imali neke svoje šanse, oni su naravno stisnuli na kraju, išli su na sve ili ništa, imali su par prilika, ali eto, na kraju su mogli čak doći i do punog plijena u zadnjim sekundama utakmice, golman je to nekako koji je ušao fenomenalno skino i na kraju bod. Zadovoljni smo bodom i u gostima protiv Olimpije i zadovoljni smo.
Mađit, od kar ste se vrnili u Slovenijo, nekako rastete u formi. Zdi se da se znova dobro počutite u Radomlja. Kako vi nekako doživljate to vaše drugo obdobje tu?
Pa mislim da sam dosta zreliji igrač ove sezone nego prošle i dosta sam naučio. Nakon povrede, prije 2 godine sam ja mučio sam sa povredom i onda sam došao tu u Sloveniju gdje mislim da sam dosta toga naučio. Ta posla mi je dobro došla i sad je hvala Bogu dobro krenulo. Opet sam tu nazad i nadam se da ću nastaviti pomagati ekipi i zabijati golove.